We are ready to start modeling the project, and we will start by drawing the slabs. But first, I will hide all layers except the one for the ground floor bitmap, and I will create a new layer where I will place all the auxiliary curves that will be used for drawing some objects. So I call this auxiliary curves, choose a red color for example, and make it current. Actually, I already had one rectangle drawn before that I will move onto that layer. So I do right click and change object layer. Now, also we need to make sure we are going to work on the ground floor. So from the level manager, we can click on this construction plane icon in order that everything we draw will be created on that ground floor elevation. And same thing if we are going to work from the top viewport. Slabs can be created either from rectangular boundaries or from curves. So we're going to use the rectangular boundary for the exterior slab and from curves option for the interior one. But we're going to draw a closed curve that defines the boundary of the interior slab. So we're going to run polyline command and draw the polyline. If this line doesn't identify the curve below, we need to hide momentarily that layer to pick it up. We're going to run the curve command to draw this curved contour. Run the polyline again. There we go. Now we need to make a mirror of this curve. First we're going to join it, and we can run the mirror command, pick the middle point and a vertical axis. We just need to draw two more segments to close this curves into a single one. We need to select them and run the join command again and make sure the resulting curve is a closed curve. Now let's draw the slabs. We have this curve on the zero elevation and this other one on the ground floor elevation, which is 10 centimeters up. So when we run the slab command, there are some insert options available, such as the style or the alignment, which is set to top right now. And if we disable the project, we're going to draw this slab exactly in the same position as where the rectangle is. And for this upper slab, we're going to run the slab from curves command that we can choose from this icon. In this case, we're going to set the slab thickness to 0.1. The slab thickness is something that can be edited by style, or you can overwrite by object from these insert options. And also the alignment to top. So we need to select the curves, and the slab will be created already on top of the other slab.